Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss about photoelectric type transducers. A photoelectric transducer can be defined as a transducer which changes energy from light to electrical. So a photoelectric transducers are mostly designed with semiconducting materials. Basically, this transducer utilizes an element like photosensitive, which can be used for etching of electrons as a light beam shoots up through it. Regarding the photoelectric type transducers, we have three categories are possible. The first type is photoemissive type, in which there is an emission of electrons are possible with respect to the intensity of light exposed over it. Whereas we have the next option, photoconductive type photoelectric transducers, where we are expecting change of resistance of a material with respect to the intensity of light illuminated over it. The third one is photovoltaic type photoelectric transducers, which generates an EMF which is proportional to the radiation of intensity. In these three types, photoemissive and photoconductive type photoelectric transducers are named as passive type transducers because it requires an external power supply, whereas photovoltaic type transducers are to be named as active because it is inducing its own EMF. And then if you go for further explanation regarding types of photoelectric transducers, we already know that we have three options. The first one is change of resistance, to be named as photoconductive cell, whereas there is a change of output current with respect to the intensity of light falls on it, that to be named as photoemissive cell, where the third one is the output voltage of the semiconductor changes. These are the three types of photoelectric transducers available. Now we are start discussing about photoemissive type transducer. A photoemissive cell converts light energy into electrical energy. So you already known that light energy consists of photons. So when the light photons hits over the cathode of a photoemissive cell, we are expecting the movement of charges from the anode. From cathode to anodes, electrons are emitted from the cathode to the anode. So anode is to be worked as a collector which collects the electrical energy. So the magnitude of the current is directly proportional to the intensity of light passed through it. So this one to be named as photoemissive cell. The anode and cathode materials are coated with photosensitive materials such as cesium antimony. If we want to increase the amplitude of the current from the photoemissive cell, we are working with the next option, photo multiplier tube. We could say it is an amplifier circuit of increasing the current from the photoemissive cell. So when electrons moving at a high velocity strike an appropriate material to be named as a dianode, the material emits a greater number of electrons than it was struck from the earlier case. So by this diagram, you can notice that it's a photo multiplier tube consists of several number of diodes. The first one is here. So whenever you start saying of a photoemissive cell, we have only one cathode, and opposite to cathode we have anode. Whereas here you can notice that when the fast moving photons are hit by the cathode, it emits electrons. So electrons are emitted from the cathode that hits by the dianode. So dianode is supplied with high positive potential, by means that the fast moving electrons hit over the dianode will reproducing with a multiple amount of fast moving electrons from the dianode stage 1. And again, it is again multiplied by twice. Then you can notice that with respect to the increasing of dianode stages, the current produced from the system is increased. So you can notice that the amplification of the original current will be of the order of 10 power 5 to 10 power 9 times the earlier stage or initial stage of cathode to anode. So this one is a most important material what we are using with photo emissive cells to increase the sensitivity of the device. If we want to discuss about the second type of photoelectric type transducers, it is photoconductive cells, or you say photoresistive cell. A photoconductive cell converts the light energy into an electrical response signals. Even this one also made up of semiconductor materials such as cadmium selenide, cadmium telluride, zinc selenide, zinc sulfide, like that materials to be named as photosensitive element. So you just notice the diagram. We just say the work function of a photoconductive cell. So a photoconductive cell is a sensing element, is coated over the ceramic base for the conducting medium. So when light rays incident on this photo semiconductor material, it was noticed that their conductivity increases. Otherwise we say resistance of the material goes on decreasing with respect to the increasing intensity of the light falls over it. So the magnitude of current is directly proportional to the intensity of light passes through it. So this gives an electrical response signal with respect to the intensity of light, where we are converting light energy into electrical response signal. This one to be named as photoconductive cell, or otherwise photoresistive cell. Regarding the types of photoresistive cells, normally cadmium sulfide, cadmium selenide, cadmium sulfoselenide is deposited over the zigzag pattern, separating by two metal coated areas acting as an electrodes. So these zigzag type materials are to be coated over the ceramic material or ceramic base for insulating medium. This type of zigzag arrangement of photoconductive materials or photosensitive elements will improve the sensitivity of the device. So photo cells are made in wide range of sizes, from 1/8 of inch in diameter to over 1 inch of diameter. So you just notice the diagram here. It's giving the relation between intensity of illumination versus the cell resistance. You can notice that there is a 2 to 3 fold time decreasing in resistance of the material is expected. Otherwise, 2 to 3 fold times increasing conductivity of the material is expected with respect to the increasing of intensity of light over it. So this one to be named as photoconductive cells or photoresistive transducers, which converts light energy into electrical response signals. The last two topics what we discussed are passive type transducers, because that photosensitive tube or otherwise photosensitive materials and photoconductive materials requires an external electrical circuit diagram to produce an energy. So those are to be named as passive type transducers, whereas we have the next option, it is photovoltaic transducers. So a photovoltaic cell is an active type transducer. The current starts flowing into the photovoltaic cell when the load is connected to it. So you know about the concept of photoelectric effect, or you say photovoltaic effect. So whenever light is incident on a semiconducting material, it was noticed that the intensity of light is absorbed by the electrons, then it start moving from one end to opposite end. So that movement of charges to be named as electricity. So we say it is photoelectric effect or photovoltaic effect. So the movements of electrons develop the current in the cell, and the current is known as photoelectric current, where we are expecting change of light energy into electrical energy indirect. And regarding the type of photovoltaic cells, we have two options. One is a photodiode. It's a pure semiconducting materials which converts light into current. So the electrons of the semiconductor material start moving when the photodiode absorbs the light energy. The response time of photodiode is very less, and it is designed for working in reverse bias circuit. Now we go for the second option of a photovoltaic effect transducers. It is phototransistors. It's a device that converts the light energy into electrical energy and also it produces both current and voltage. So we already known about a transistor is a device which have two p-n junctions. So whenever light is incident on emitter, there is a movement of charges from emitter to collector is expected. So we are achieving with variation of current and voltage. So the semiconductor material is which is enclosed in an opaque container in which the light easily reaches to the photosensitive elements. I think you understand these topics regarding photoelectric effect transducers, and then we'll meet you soon with the next topic. Thank you.